Welcome to KSR Data Vision YouTube channel. In this playlist, we were seeing about the DAG functions. So let's continue to learn more. In today's video, we are going to see what is a measure. Just to give a recap, in the last video, we were seeing about the new column. So we were writing a new column whenever the data is incomplete. We were trying to add new column. So year, month, day, quarter, week number, weekday, week month. So these are the additional columns which we added previously. Now these are all called calculated columns. Calculated columns are columns which exist in the data set. It was not there, but using the DAG functions, we were able to do it. Now coming to measure. Now what is a measure? Now measure is just a calculation that can be applied to any visual. Now let me see a few examples. Let's say I have a table where I'll just have country and I'll have something called sales. So what happens is the total sales is 141 million. That gets divided across country. Now, what if the client needs something called average? What you will do? You will just go here, select this drop down. Instead of sum, you will select an average. Now, this is an average of sales with respect to country. Now, I'll give you one more example. In this, let's say I have something called category. So with respect to category, I'll take out the sales. Now again, this is sum of sales. I need not need sum of sales. I need average. So I have to go here, again change to average. One more example, take a table. Now this time I will take something called business category. Again, I'll take sales. Now again, this time it's something called sum of sales. I'll go again, change it to average. Now what is the effort that is needed? Every time I am dragging something called average sales to the visual and then changing it to average. For every visual, I am changing it. So don't you think that this average is a generic function that can be applied to any visual? Now let's go and write a measure for it. So what I'll do, I'll go and write a new measure, and the measure name I'll call it as average of sales. Now I have a function called average. Now average of what? Definitely it is going to be bike data of sales. Now I have written a measure. Now how do you differentiate that it's a measure? The measure will be iconed with a calculator symbol. One thing you have to remember is calculated column will exist in the table. These are all the calculated column that we have already written. But when you come for measure, it's not going to save anywhere in a data set, but it's just a calculation. Now in this page, for this three visuals, I have dragged the sales and then I have changed it to average. Every time I cannot do it. So instead, what I've written is I have written one function called average of sales. Let's redo it again. But this time I will just take out country and I will just take out, rather than taking this sales and then changing it to average, directly I can add this average to the visual. Now again, I'll take it. This time I will add business segment and directly I can add a average. Now again, I'll take a table. This time I will take category. And this time again, I will add something called average of sales. If you compare all these three visuals with these three visuals, the values will be same. But here, what I've done is I have taken the sales and then change it to average, but directly I can write a measure. Measure is a calculation that can be applied to any visual. It will actually reduce the burden of changing across the columns. Now, what I've written, it's an average. You can write minimum, you can write maximum, you can write total sales, you can sum it up everything. It is like a generic function that can be applied to any visual. So this is what is measure. In the real time, your client will not accept like adding a new columns as you like, because the data set, it will be client's data set. You cannot add as you like. You have to be specific. You want to understand the requirement and then you want to write it down. So here, rather than dragging the sales and then changing according to your need, I have written a generic functions which is average of sales, and I have then dragged that measure into a different visuals. You can get the average with respect to different visuals. So this will reduce your effort that you had initially put up. So thank you for watching. We'll again come back with a new video shortly.